Start.
Hello dear children, I hope you all are fine. Welcome to the new academic year. I am Tanzeem Tisikar, your assistant teacher. Now do you remember, in the month of April, you have learned lesson number 1, right? That is Northern Mountain. What you have learned in that lesson? You have learned about the Greater Himalayas, Lesser Himalaya and Outer Himalaya. So do you, now let's have a look in that lesson. After that, you have to read the chapter and you have to find out the answer and you have to solve the worksheet. Okay.
Good morning students. Welcome class 4. Today we will learn SST lesson Northern Mountains. Northern Mountains, the mountains which are north side to the India. Lesson number 1 is the Northern Mountains. Do you know that 9 out of 10 highest mountain peaks in the world are located just one mountain range? Just in one mountain range. Which mountain is that? Well, it's the Himalaya. Himalaya. The Northern Mountains include the Himalayas and the Karakoram mountain ranges here. Himalayan ranges is the highest mountain ranges in the world. As we saw in the previous slide, Himalayan ranges are the highest mountain ranges in the world. What is mean by Himalaya? Himalaya means abode of snow. Abode means house. Hima means ice and alaya means home. Means the home of ice, the abode of snow is called Himalaya. Most of the Himalayan peaks remains covered with snow throughout the year. Here you can see the Himalayan ranges in India stretch from Jammu and Kashmir in the north to Arunachal Pradesh in the northeast. From Jammu and Kashmir in the north to Arunachal Pradesh in the northeast. Here you can see the Himalayas consist of 3 parallel ranges. Number 1 is the Greater Himalayas, which is called Himadri. Number 2, the Lesser Himalayas, which is called Himachal. And number 3, the Outer Himalayas, which is called Shivalik. Now we will learn in detail. Several glaciers originate from these mountains. What is mean by glaciers? Glaciers means a large, dense ice body which consistently moves down. It's called glaciers. Many rivers like Ganga and Yamuna originate from these glaciers. Mount Everest is the highest peak of the Himalayas with the height of 8,850 meters approximately. It is also the highest peak of the world and is located in the Nepal. The Mount Everest is located in the Nepal. As well as the Kanchenjunga and Nanda Devi. Kanchenjunga and Nanda Devi, these are the prominent peaks at the Indian part of the Himalayas. These are the Indian part of the Himalayas. Now we will see in detail about Himadri, the Greater Himalayas, Himadri. Number 1 slide here we saw. Himadri is the northernmost and longest continuous mountain range and also form a natural boundary between India and China. These Himadri ranges form a natural boundary between two countries, India and China. At some places, huge masses of ice moves down the mountain slopes, which are called glaciers. When these glaciers reach to the plains, they melt down and flow as a river. Vegetations like mosses and lichen are found in some parts of these Himadri ranges. Farming is not possible in this region. Why? Because here you can see the area which is covered with ice throughout the year, and the area is also hard. So farming is not possible in these ranges. Now number two range, the middle or lesser Himalaya, which is called Himachal, we will see in detail. Himachal ranges is located between Himadri and Shivalik. The upper part is Himadri and the lower is Shivalik. In the between, the middle line, which is called Himachal. The Himachal is the lower than Himadri. The mountain ranges had some beautiful valleys such as Chamba, Kulu and Kangra. The famous hill stations of Shimla, Mussoorie, Nainital, Darjeeling are located here in this range. Which range? The Himachal ranges. Now here you can see some important mountain passes like Rohtang and Zojila of some Himachal Pradesh are found in this region. Rohtang Pass and Zojila Pass. The Himachal ranges has thick forests that are covered with pine, oak, devdar and fir trees. The lower slopes have orchids as well as tea plantations are found in the eastern part of these ranges. Now eastern part, as we saw in the previous slides, Arunachal Pradesh. So there we can see tea plantation of that ranges. The next outer Himalaya Shivalik, Trans-Himalayan ranges and Purvanchal ranges we will see in the next week lesson. Thank you. Good morning class 4th. Last time we were discussing about lesson number 1, SST lesson number 1, Nadan Mountain. And in the Nadan Mountains we have seen the Himadri as well as we have seen the Himachal ranges, and today we will be discussing about Shivalik ranges. The third line, Shivalik ranges. So basically what is mean by Shivalik? Shivalik is a Sanskrit word which means belonging to Lord Shiva. The Shivaliks are the lowest and narrowest. You can see here. Lowest and the narrowest range in the entire Himalayan ranges. You can see here the entire Himalayan ranges. Or Himalayan system, lying at the southern part of the Himadri and the Himachal of the Himalayan range. Shivaliks rise steeply from northern plains of India and Pakistan and run parallel to the main ranges of the Himalayas. You can see here. Here you can see Shivaliks rise steeply from the northern plains of the India and Pakistan and runs parallel to the main ranges of the Himalayas. The Shivalik and the Himachal ranges are separated by deep and narrow valleys, and these are called dunes. Here I will explain. The outer Shivalik hills, the Shivalik hills and the lesser Himalaya. These are separated by the deep and narrow valleys, and this area is called dunes. So Dehradun is a one of the example of these dunes. These slopes are, you can see here, these slopes are covered with thick forest and variety of wildlife is found here. Much of the land is used for growing crops like rice, potatoes and maize. Now we will see Trans-Himalayan range. The Trans-Himalayan range lies to the northwest of the Himalayas. Beyond the river Indus, I will tell you later on where is the place of Indus River. This region consists of many mountain ranges. Here you can see, like Karakoram Range and Pir Panjal Range, as well as the Jaskar and the Kailash ranges. K2, here you can see, K2 or Mount Godwin Austin. Its height is 8611 meters. This K2 is the second highest peak in the world. And this is of the Karakoram Range. Now we have seen here. It is in the Karakoram Range and it is one of the greatest range of Asia. This is a Pir Panjal Range. Now we will move forward and we will see Purvanchal Range. The Purvanchal Range lies along the eastern border. The eastern border of India, and these ranges are not very high like other mountain ranges. They are covered with thick forest as well as the northeastern hills here. Now previous slide we have seen here. Here we see Garo, Khasi, Jaintia Hills as well as Mizo Hills and Naga Hills. Here you can see. Now let us see forward. Life in the region. Now life in the region we will see. The Himadri, first Himadri we will discuss. The Himadri region is very cold throughout the year. And this makes it very difficult for people as well as for animals to live here, to survive here. Jammu, Kashmir and parts of Himachal Pradesh and Sikkim lie in this region, in the Himadri region. In the Himadri, the Wooler Lake and Dal Lake are two famous lakes in Jammu and Kashmir are found here. Houseboats and shikaras are also found here. Tourism is the main source of the income in this Himadri region. Tourism is a main source. The people of this state or the people of these ranges keep kangri. You can see here. Keep kangri, a small pot with burning coal to keep themselves warm. The main festival celebrated here is Eid and Shivratri, Mahashivratri. If we see Sikkim, in the Sikkim has people belonging of three main tribes which are Bhutia, Lepcha and Nepali. Women in the Sikkim wear a long skirt. You can see here. Wear a long skirt which is called Baku. B-A-K-U. Baku. The place is famous for its orchids. The beautiful flowers, orchids. Now we will see the life in Himachal ranges. There are many beautiful hill stations in the Himachal range, such as Shimla, Dalhousie, Kullu, Manali, which are also the major tourist spots. In the Gadwal and Kumaon, in the Gadwal and Kumaon ranges or regions of the Uttarakhand, Gadwal and Kumaon falls in the Uttarakhand. People are mostly farmers here. People do farming here. Which type of farming they are doing, that we will see. But here, Mussoorie and Nainital, you can see here. Mussoorie and Nainital are the popular hill stations here in the Himachal ranges. Darjeeling in West Bengal, see here. Darjeeling in West Bengal is known for tea gardens or tea plantations. This is famous for tea plantation or tea gardens. The climate in this region is suitable for tea plantation. As well as you can see here, rice, maize, barley, fruits and vegetables are also grown here. Let's move forward. Sheep, animals like sheep and goats are reared in these hills. In the Kullu region, people mostly speak Hindi language. And Dasera is the main festival of this region, Dasera. Thick forest. Now we will move forward the life in the region of Shivalik. Thick forest and a variety of wildlife are found in the Shivalik ranges. You can see here slopes of these mountains. The slopes of these mountains are used for terrace farming. You can see here the example of terrace farming. As well as the cattle rearing is common in these Shivalik ranges. Here people eat potato, rice and maize. These food crops are commonly grown here. Okay, now we will see the importance of Himalayas. What is the importance of Himalayas in our life, in our country? The first is, high mountains of the Himalayas act as a barrier against the enemies and plays an important role in the defense of our country. So this plays a major part. The second is, it protects our country from cold winds coming from Siberia. Siberia is to the north side. So it is protecting our country. And last importance of Himalayas is, the Himalayas are the sources of major rivers like Ganga, Indus, Brahmaputra and their tributaries. These rivers make our land fertile. These rivers flow in the Northern Plains, which is our next topic, Northern Plains, that we will discuss next time. I hope that you have understood this lesson in a better manner. Thank you. Hello, my dear students of class 4th. Good morning, one and all. Last 2 weeks, we were discussing about lesson number 1, Northern Mountain. I tried to occupy all the points related to Northern Mountain. And I hope that you have understood the lesson. So today, we will be discussing about question and answers regarding this lesson. So are you ready? Let's see. Question number 1. What is meant by the word Himalaya? Name 3 parallel ranges of the Himalayas. The Himalaya in Sanskrit word, Hima means snow and Alaya means house. The house of snow, literally meaning abode of snow. So the word Himalaya means the abode of snow. And the Himalayas consist of 3 parallel ranges. They are the Greater Himalayas, the Lesser Himalayas and the Outer Himalayas. Himadri, Himachal and Shivalik. Have you understood? Let's move forward. Question number 2. What are dunes? Give an example. Dunes are formed between Lesser Himalayas and Shivaliks. The longitudinal valleys lying between Lesser Himalayas and Shivaliks are called dunes. The Shivalik and the Himachal ranges are separated by deep and narrow valleys called dunes. So here Dehradun is one such examples of dunes. Question number 3 is, Why is the Himachal range of the Himalayas famous? If we see, the Himachal range is famous for its scenic beauty. The Himachal is lower than Himadri. So, this mountain range has some beautiful valleys such as Chamba, Kullu and Kangra. The famous hill stations of Shimla, Mussoorie, Nainital, Almora and Darjeeling are located in this range. People visit these hill stations to escape the summer heat. Winters are cold and summers are cool and pleasant. Orchids, flowers and tea plantations are found here. Himachal derives its name from Himalayas. Hima means snow and Achala means mountain. And it has various snowy mountains which are a very famous spots for tourist. We have discussed here Chamba, Kullu and Kangra. Okay, and the hill stations also we have mentioned here, which are Shimla, Mussoorie, Nainital, Almora and Darjeeling. So, because of the scenic beauty, because of the panoramic beauty, because of the abundant beauty, the Himachal range of the Himalayas is the famous. Now, let's see the fourth number question. How would you summarize the life of the people in the Himadri region? Okay, so the life in the Himadri region, if we are discussing here, the Himalayas. First, we will speak about the Himalayas. The Himalayas is one wonder of the nature, and its high snow clad mountains are rich with flora and fauna, and its scenic beauty have enchanted one and all, as we know. The cold climate in the Himadri region makes very difficult for people as well as for the animals to live. Tourism is a main source of income, so people keep their houseboats and shikaras for tourists. People keep kangri. Kangri means a small pot of burning coal. They keep this kangri under their outer loose clothes to keep themselves warm, so they can fight with the cold. And the main festivals celebrated here are Eid and Shivratri. Women in Sikkim wear a long skirt called Baku. So this is the life of the people in the Himadri region. The five number question and the last question is, in which range of the Himalayas do you think crops are cultivated? Give reasons. Okay. So most of the people living here means in the outer Himalayas, in the Shivalik Himalayas, Shivalik ranges. In this range of Himalayas, crops are cultivated in the outer Himalayas, which is called Shivalik, because the Shivaliks are the lowest and the narrowest range in the entire Himalayan system. It has an average height of about 900 to 1200 meters. Much of the land is used for growing crops like rice, potatoes and maize. Slopes of these mountains are used for terrace farming of tea, herbs, etc. Most of the people living here dependent on farming and growing their own crop or own food. They use yaks for the transport. The outer Himalayas means the Shivaliks are fit for the cultivation of crops, as the weather is not very cold as compared to the greater Himalayas. So, in this range, in the Shivalik range, the outer Himalayan range of the Himalayas, I think crops are cultivated here. So, I hope that these five questions you have understood. I hope that you revise these five questions. Thank you.